Good evening to all you people out there on YouTube land. This is Dead Rayman or Walking Reporting. And I'm going to make this video of some of my Build-A-Bear stuffed animals. Some, but not all of them. Just because I want to keep this video as short as possible because I got to move on the fly. It is Friday night. They're going to show Whose Line Is Anyway. It's not at 9 o'clock. And I got to, you know, move on the fly if I want to get things done as soon as possible. So let's get on with this this collection. So first things first, I have Shiva, have this nice red panda. She was part of the WWF collection. That's World Wildlife Fund, not whatever WWE, which is why World Wrestling Entertainment was renamed WWE, because WWF would have sued them. So this is Shiva, named her after one of my favorite World Combat characters. And this is Red Panda, because, you know, red pandas are an endangered species. I just felt that this was the cutest red panda. And I got her in the store in 2013. I think it was November 2013, and I thought I was never going to get this, because it's a long and horrible story. So yeah, this is Shiva. Yep, that's Shiva. And I even got a certificate of authenticity that I got in the mail a few months later down the road of getting Shiva. As a matter of fact, even as I make this video, it's still at my parents' house. All right. All right, next up, one of my licensed Build-A-Bears is Fluffy the Unicorn. If you all have ever watched Despicable Me, you know who this is. It's so fluffy, I'm gonna die. It's so fluffy. Yeah, this was a must have in my collection. I have just about fluffy everything. Fluffy, I even have a fluffy pillow pet, which I got at Dave and Buster's years ago. And there's his unicorn. Oh, this was too cute not to pass up. This is, you know, released during the time when Despicable Me 3 was released. Very lovely. And also, during the time Despicable Me 3 was released, we have Dave the Minion. His overalls cannot stay on that much anymore. And you can see on his, it's on his right side, he's got some stains, which I'm gonna do some spot cleaning on whenever I get a chance, possibly this weekend or maybe Monday, depending on how busy I am, because my dad has to have surgery on his fingers, and depending on how soon my mom can get home by 11:40, I may or may not be able to go to physical therapy. So anyways, yeah. And next in my Minions collection, we have Kevin. He was my third minion. He's just too cute. I just can't help it. These minions usually come along with me for like traveling. They're like my traveling companions, comfort buddies, whatever. Kevin. Yeah. Unfortunately, Kevin is one of the many Build-A-Bears which sound boxes I've had to pull out because the sound box battery has bought the farm, gone flat. Anyhow. And then, breaking away from the Minions collection, I have Gidget. This is when the Secret Life of Pets came out. Yep, and there's her little paw there. Nice little bow on her head. The very same night I got Gidget, and the Gidget dress, and got her little tiara, I actually went and saw The Secret Life of Pets 2 at the Transit Drive-In, which is the same drive-in I went to go see the Super Mario Brothers movie at. Sorry about that, folks. I'm trying to move on the fly as quick as I can. All right. And here we have Bob. He was the second minion that came into my Despicable Me collection that's growing ever so quickly. Yeah, Bob is just a cutie. Okay, sorry about that, folks. I had to go scoundering around the apartment for this little scoundrel. This is the first ever minion I adopted, and this was Stuart. This, of course, Kevin and Bob were part of the Minions collection when the first Minions movie came out back in 2015. And I was gonna get his guitar, but you know, I passed it up and I'm glad I did, because otherwise Stuart would have been very expensive. Yeah, so I'm glad I got Stuart. I mean, he's been my travel buddy for many years. I mean, the first time I ever took him traveling was when I took him to Cleveland, Ohio for when me and my parents went on a small vacation. And yeah, Stuart was my traveling buddy. And then he and I believe Dave were traveling buddies when I went to go see my sister in Texas. So yeah, this is Stuart. I set him down in the dun pile. Let me get some of these folks out. Here we have Michelangelo from the 2012 Ninja Turtles cartoon on Nickelodeon. Michelangelo has always been my favorite Ninja Turtle of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I always loved him because he's a party animal. He's a party dude. Yeah, everyone has their favorite Ninja Turtle. And I couldn't pass up Michelangelo. I got his nunchucks too, but his nunchucks are most likely at my parents' house in storage, in their garage. Yeah. And it's amazing how the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles were named after Renaissance artists. And maybe you guys could learn how you'll learn your Renaissance painters from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles as well. So, Michelangelo. Oh, and another nice thing about Michelangelo is that he's got Velcro on the straps of his shell, so the Build-A-Bear workers could take it off and he could get stuffed. All right. Okay, and here we have 2016 Sonic the Hedgehog. See his foot there, Sonic the Hedgehog. I got him in 2016. At first, I thought there were a lot of things online that were web exclusive. Like, I thought he was just going to be only seen on the web and not in the stores. But boy, was I ever so wrong. My parents went to the mall, Galleria Mall in Buffalo, New York, where they have the Build-A-Bear store. I know there's a Build-A-Bear store at Marketplace Mall as well. Oh, wait, no, scratch that. I meant to say Eastview Mall. Oh, I am so sorry, folks. Well, anyways, and I got this Sonic the Hedgehog toy, and I got a small Tails, and I got his shirt. I don't know what else he had, but there were a lot of Sonic things that were online exclusive, like the Golden Ring and a print of Sonic the Hedgehog with a bear. And yeah, it was so cute. I was really excited when I saw this Sonic the Hedgehog just as I was nearing the Build-A-Bear store. I felt like the 2-year-old in me was screaming because I see Sonic. He's got to come in my collection. And the next Sonic plushie I have is my 2020 Sonic shirt, or my 2020 Sonic plushie. I call him I call him Sonic 2.0 because he's like the movie Sonic. Some people jokingly call him Ugly Sonic because he kind of looks like Ugly Sonic from the old Sonic trailers before they revamped his appearance to make him look less ugly and less scary. Ooh, and oh yeah, look at that foot. Don't mind him wearing a Smurfs hoodie. I went through hell getting this Sonic plushie because when I went to the Build-A-Bear store before it was supposed to be released, that was the stupidest thing I would ever do because I was like going in there, I didn't see this, and I was like, where are the Sonic plushies? And then the lady goes, oh, we don't get them until tomorrow. And I just felt like a total idiot. And then they sold out like hotcakes online. And then I went to the Build-A-Bear store in March of 2020 trying to get them in the store for the second time. Second attempt was unsuccessful. Well, then my mom, hearing about my belly aching and me singing the blues, she finally ordered this Sonic. And, you know, I finally, and you know, one Sunday, I was over at my parents' house and she hands it over to me and I was like so happy. Well, sadly, that time at the Build-A-Bear store in 2020 was the last time I'd be there. That was, well, because, you know, COVID and all. So, yeah, that's my little story about Sonic 2.0. Okay, now, here we have Tails. This is from when Sonic the Hedgehog 2 came out. Oh, and before any of you ask any questions, I do not have Sonic from 2002 Sonic movie, Sonic the Hedgehog 2, or even Knuckles, because I am not going to go through the torture that I went through trying to get Sonic from the 2020 movie. So this is Tails. Yeah, he's just so cute in person. I mean, I wanted to get him just as soon as possible, but unfortunately, you know, I was sick, like, sometime after I went to go see Sonic the Hedgehog 2 in the movie theater, and I was so sick that I didn't want to do a review on Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Before you ask, I was sick with a stomach flu compared to what my folks had, which was COVID. And I was desperate to get this Tails plush. Well, I finally mustered the courage to tell my mom, can you get me this Tails plushie online? And she did. And so I waited. So, you know, I actually waited and got to wait until Monday to get this. I think it was Monday to get this Tails plushie. And he is just cute. He is better in person. Can't, no words to say this little fella. He has been in a lot of pictures and will probably be in some more as maybe, well, I don't know. I'm paying too much attention to my Mario plushies that will be seen later in the video. So, yeah. Okay, sorry I had to cut off again, but I had to wrangle up another license Build-A-Bear. This is Puss in Boots. They released this Puss in Boots plush in time for the Puss in Boots movie. The new one, Puss in Boots 2, The Last Wish. And this is just adorable. I've always wanted a proper Puss in Boots, a proper Puss in Boots plush. And my wish was granted for this Christmas. It was the last Christmas gift I had opened that was under the tree. And my mom, and of course, you know, it was packaged. And so my mom's like having to open up the tape and all on the box and all. And once I saw the Puss in Boots plush come out, I was like, give it to me, Mom, give it to me. And I was like hugging him and kissing him and stuff. And he's also got a sound. I'm sorry if you can't hear that well, because you can hear my air conditioner running. Yep, got that sucker in yesterday. So Puss in Boots is just lovely. His cape, his belt, his hat. He does have a sword, but I don't want to have to keep looking for it and delay taping. And then we have my Animal Crossing plushies. Well, just Isabelle and Tom Nook, who you will see in a moment. This is Isabelle, and she's in her summer outfit. And I remember how they, when they first came out with the Build-A-Bears for Animal Crossing, they had this virtual line thing. And I have to say, just like Sonic the Hedgehog 2020 plush, they sold out like hotcakes. And, you know, disappointment. Yes. Well, eventually these guys would be sold online and no virtual line. So I was like telling my mom, get me one of these Isabel plushies as soon as possible before they sell out like hotcakes again. Don't mind me saying hotcakes. I was trying to talk like Lisa Douglas from Green Acres. So this is Isabel, and she is just lovely. I mean, she's gone through the ringer. I mean, she's had spot treatments, gone through some cleaning and stuff, and even had to be restuffed some. But Isabel's still lovely. And she's got a sound. Sorry you can't hear it that loud, Cot. I'm sorry you can't hear it that loud, folks. And the next Animal Crossing plush I have is Tom Nook. He is lovely. And I also have him in a summer outfit, just like Isabel. And like Isabel, he also has a sound. That's Tom Nook. Next up, we have I have my Mario plushies from Build-A-Bear. Here we have Yoshi. Yeah, at the time I got this Yoshi, they had a green Yoshi like what you're seeing here, and a light blue Yoshi. I couldn't pass up this green Yoshi though, because he's just so cute. I've always wanted a nice Yoshi plush instead of the whiny small one I got at the Fry's Electronics store back in 2010. Yeah, such a lovely Yoshi. Bowser! I think I got him in 2018 because his tush tag says 2018. And he's getting a little floppy because... you know, ever since I saw Super Mario Brothers movie, I've been taking him all over the place where I go, restaurants, appointments, whatever, and Bowser needs to get some stuffing inside of him. And he also needs to have a sound chip out because battery is flat. So pretty soon I'll have to stuff up Bowser. Don't know when, but Bowser is just so charming. I mean, he's expensive, but he was well worth it, folks. Yeah, he's cute. Well, that's about it for my Build-A-Bear Workshop collection. So, until next time, this is Dead Rayman Walking, signing off.